Welcome to my channel Lenovate. Today we will going to discuss some of the major spinal cord injuries and some of the major lesions of the spinal cord that occur because of the lesions in the tracts that run along the spinal cord, and most of the nerve fibers or the gamma motor neurons or the upper or the lower motor neurons. So before going to discuss the lesions of the spinal cord and different types of the spinal cord syndrome, we should know some of the few terms related to the spinal cord injuries. So now starting from these terms that are the important terms, starting from the spastic paralysis. So what is a spastic paralysis? It is mostly called as the hypertonicity of a muscle, because the muscle has a specific tone. So if the tone of a muscle increase, then this is a hypertonicity, and because of the hypertonicity, there is a spasm of a muscle. That is called as the spastic paralysis. Because of the over hypertonicity, there is no function of the muscle. That's why the paralysis occurs. Then the another term used mostly is the paresthesia. The paresthesia is simply the sensation of a pins and needles. Like pins and needles are sensing on the body. Then the hypertonicity. The hypertonicity means simply the increase in the muscle tone, while that of the hypotonicity is the decrease in the muscle tone. Hypertonicity ultimately lead to the spastic paralysis, while that of the hypotonicity lead to the Flaccid paralysis, in which there is a decrease in the muscle tone. Then the tremors. The tremors are the to and fro movement that is irregular and involuntary of the agonist and the antagonistic muscle group. Yeah, means that different muscle groups work in opposite directions and there is a non-involuntary rhythmic contractions. These are called as the tremors. It can be intentional tremors and it can be resting tremors in the Parkinson's disease. Then the muscle atrophy. The muscle atrophy is just simply the wasting of a muscle or the denervation of the muscle. The most important is the Babinski sign that is mostly used in the spinal cord lesions. What is the Babinski sign? Here you can take an example that if there is a superficial reflex by taking a needle-like pin at the lower sole of the feet, then there will be a plantar flexion of the big toe and the flexion of all the toes. When there is a flexion of all the toes and the plantar flexion of big toe, this is called as the negative Babinski sign or the normal Babinski sign. You can say the Babinski sign is normal when it is called as the negative, while that of the abnormal Babinski sign is called as the positive Babinski sign. So in normal, there is a negative Babinski sign presence. Now coming to the lesions of the upper and the lower motor neuron. If there is a lesion in the upper motor neuron of a descending tract, there will be everything that go increase. Firstly, there will be an increase of the muscle tone that is called as the hypertonicity. There is an increased hypertonicity, there is a spasmic paralysis. There is also increase in the reflexes, which is called as the hyperreflex action. Or there is an increase in the hyperreflexivity. Then there is also increase in the muscle contraction. So you can say there is a hyperreflexivity or the hypertonicity or the increase in the muscle contraction. Then there is a presence of a positive Babinski sign, that is the dorsiflexion of the big toe and the extension of all the toes. So this is the sign of the Babinski is positive here, that is abnormal in the upper motor neuron lesion. And the upper motor neuron lesion in some of the spinal cord syndromes and in the mostly corticospinal tracts, extrapyramidal tracts, it can occur, or it is due to any injury towards the spinal cord. Now coming to the lower motor neuron. So the causes that cause the lower motor neuron lesion is mostly the poliomyelitis that we will going to discuss further on. So what signs can you see in the lower motor neuron include the decrease in the muscle tone called as the hypotonicity. That is, we have discussed that term, that is a hypotonicity. Then there is a decrease in the reflexes. So there is also the hyporeflexivity. Hyporeflexivity is also seen in the lower motor neuron lesions. Then there is a muscle atrophy. there's a decrease in the muscle contraction or there's a wasting of the muscle, that is called as the muscle atrophy. Then what happens to the Babinski sign? The Babinski sign is normal in the lower motor neuron lesions. That is, the normal Babinski sign is called as the negative Babinski sign, that is normal in the lower motor neuron lesions. Now coming to some major spinal cord syndromes that include the most of the common complete cord syndromes and some of the Babinski signs syndrome that include the Brown Scabbard or the Sphingomyelia. So here we are going to discuss these syndromes line by line. Here you can see I have drawn a spinal cord, and this is an example of a human being in which there is a showing how the responses can be disintegrated or how the muscle is wasted in which part of the spinal cord and in which part of the body. Now coming to the first, that is the most important, is a complete cord transection syndrome. If example, for example, if there is a complete cord transection, if every tract that is coming to the spinal cord or that is going to the spinal cord, going from the spinal cord that is descending, or any tract coming to the spinal cord that is a descending or the ascending tract, if these both tracts get damaged, there is a complete spinal cord syndrome. And because of the complete spinal cord syndrome, there is a loss of action of whole the body. There will be no muscle activity, no muscle contraction, no sensation, no muscle contraction, not any of the sensation is present, no any pain, no any temperature, all these things are lost. So this, that condition is called as the complete spinal cord transduction syndrome. Now the another important injury of the spinal cord is the Brown Scabbard syndrome, that is called as the hemisection of the spinal cord. So if, for example, here if the half section of the spinal cord is damaged, there will be a loss of the pain temperature pathway. Here you can see in that diagram, there will be a loss of the temperature pain pathway below the level of the lesion. For example, if the lesion have occurred here, so below the level of lesion, there will be a loss of the motor action, there will be a loss of the motor activity, there will be a muscle atrophy, there will be a paralysis below the lesion, there will be a loss of the sensation of the tactile, vibratory, proprioceptive at the same side of the lesion, below the level of lesion at the same side. But if the lesion is here, you can see this is the left side or this is the right side. But the lesion, if is on the left side, then there will be a spilaterally damage towards the tactile sensation. There is no muscle contraction, muscle atrophy at the side, left side of the body. But there will be a contralateral loss of the pain and temperature sensation. Here there is no sensation of the pain and temperature on the right side, while the other sensation are lost on the left side. So here you can see this half side of the body is involved in the muscle paralysis and half side of body is involved in the anesthesia. So this condition is called as the Brown Scabbard syndrome, and it is very severe. Also, what happens to the Babinski sign? The Babinski sign is also not normal. Now two important injuries that are the including the Sphingomyelia. So what happens in the Sphingomyelia? In the Sphingomyelia, there is a damage towards the central canal of the spinal cord. If this central canal of the spinal cord get damaged, what happens in the body? The pain and the temperature sensation are lost in the upper part of the body. In the Sphingomyelia, the effect occur in a shawl-like manner. You can see that we wear the shawl in this manner, from here in the chest region, thoracic region, and in the upper limb. The effect of the Sphingomyelia occur here, and there will be a loss of the pain and temperature pathway, but there is not a loss, or there is a normal tactile and the vibratory sensation. Because the tactile and vibratory sensation go from the posterior white column, so that's why they are normal. But there is a pain and temperature loss. Also, there is a positive Babinski sign, and there is a muscle atrophy and muscle paralysis at this level. That's called as the Sphingomyelia. Now the last, that is a very important, that is the poliomyelitis. The poliomyelitis is mostly common or disorder of the anterior gray column of the spinal cord. Here you know that this is the gray column of the spinal cord. In that part of the anterior gray column, there is a damage of the anterior motor neuron in the poliomyelitis on the both sides or on the any one side. So in this case of poliomyelitis, there is also the loss of muscle and the paralysis of muscle in the lower limbs and the lower part of the body, because the damage has occurred to the anterior motor neuron in the anterior gray column, where the alpha or the gamma motor neuron give the information towards the body. So mostly there is a loss and paralysis of the lower limbs, then coming towards the respiratory area, and there will be a loss of the pharynx, larynx, these all muscles also get their muscle atrophies, and that's why there will be a certain condition of the respiratory asthma, and then the death may occur in the poliomyelitis. So this was a general explanation about all the major spinal cord injuries. I hope you will be explained well. Thank you for watching our video.